everyone. Welcome to our first EnrichLA garden video. Today we're going to be learning about soil. Everything that you eat can be traced back to soil. For example, I'm sure you all love hamburgers, right? If you think about it, every part of the hamburger can be traced back to soil. So let's look at the burger bun. It's made from flour, which comes from wheat, which grows in soil. So if you eat meat, then your hamburger contains beef. Now, beef comes from cows, which eat grain and hay, and it all grows in soil. The best hamburgers also contain tomatoes and lettuce, and those both grow in soil. Ketchup is also made from tomatoes, big, juicy tomatoes. Now, on a piece of paper, I want you to write down your favorite food or snack. I want you to think about where that food comes from. Does it grow on the ground? Is it made from a vegetable or fruit? Does it come from an animal? What does that animal eat? If you are unsure about where something might come from, ask an adult around you or use the internet to find out. Today we're going to learn about the different parts that make up soil. Soil is made up of sand, silt, and clay. So sand has the biggest particles. If you've ever been to the beach, you know what sand feels like. It's gritty and it's rough. And because sand particles are so big, they let water run through it. After sand comes silt. Now, these particles are a little bit smaller than sand, and because they're smaller, they can hold water a little bit better. Clay is the smallest of all the particles. If you've ever played with Play-Doh, you know how smooth and silky it is. Because clay particles are so small, it's hard for air and water to pass through it. See how it holds together? This is not good for plants. The best type of soil is called loam, which contains a combination of sand, silt, and clay. Loam can retain water and oxygen levels that are good for plants. We're going to be doing a simple activity so that you can see the particles that make up soil. Make sure you have the help of an adult to do this activity. So you're going to need the following items: a container with a lid. Just make sure that it's clear so that you can see the layers. You're also going to need some soil from the garden. You don't need a lot of soil, so just grab a little bit. I'll show you. So here's some regular garden soil. You just need to get a shovel, dig some out, put it in your container. That's about all you need. So next you're going to need some water. You're just going to fill up your container about 2/3 of the way up. Then put your lid on. So once you put the lid on, give the whole container a little shake. So as you can see, all the particles are mixed up in there, but if you let it settle and just leave it for a while, you soon see the layers starting to form. Any sand or small rocks and gravel will immediately settle at the bottom of your jar because they're bigger and heavier. After sand particles, you will see silt on top. The smallest of clay particles will settle on the very top and are usually gray looking. If you see anything floating on top, that's organic matter. Organic matter is also very important to plants. You usually have to wait at least a couple hours to really let all the particles settle in the jar. So, wasn't that fun? Make sure you check on your jar because it'll change daily, okay? So now let's review. Can you name the three parts of soil? That's right, sand, silt, and clay. Do you remember what loam is? Loam is the perfect type of soil for plants. It contains sand, silt, and clay.